All right, Ninja Nerds, we're going to take a look at atlas and axis. So what we're looking at right now is atlas, C1. We're looking at the superior surface here. If you look at the superior surface, we have these little depressions here. These are called your superior articulating processes with facets right there. These are what articulate with the occipital condyles of the occipital bone to form what's called the synovial condyloid joint. Right here, we can see a little bump, right, that tubercle. That's the anterior tubercle. So this is obviously the anterior side of the cervical vertebrae. And over here is the posterior tubercle. And so this would be the posterior side of the cervical vertebrae. Over here, we have these little bumps out here. These little bumps out here are the transverse processes, okay, of the cervical vertebrae. And then we have these holes where the vertebral arteries run through. And those holes are called the transverse foramina, okay? Then you got this big hole, and that's your vertebral foramen, right? If we look over here, and again, that vertebral foramen is where the spinal cord runs through. If we look back here, we have like an articulating surface right here for the dens or the odontoid process, or C2. And that's what allows for that rotation around that point or that pivoting point of it. All right? So again, that's the articulating surface for where the odontoid process or dens of our axis articulates with. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip it over so we can get a different view here. All right, so let's take a look at the inferior view here. So these right here are your inferior articulating processes with facets. And they articulate with the superior articulating process of facets with C2 or axis. And that's what allows for a specific type of joint that I'll talk about here in a second, which is called a synovial pivot joint. We'll take a look at it here in a little bit. And then again, this is going to be the anterior side. This is the anterior tubercle. And over here, there'll be a posterior tubercle. And these are your arches. They call them the arches. This would be the anterior arch, and this would be the posterior arch back here. Again, vertebral foramen right here is where the spinal cord runs through. And again, you can see these transverse processes over here. You can still see the transverse foramina, which is where these holes where the vertebral arteries run through. Okay, so again, this is going to be our C1, or atlas. Let's take a closer look now at C2, or axis. So you can tell it's axis because it has this, like, what's called a dens or an odontoid process, this little thumb thing sticking right up. Again, this is dens or odontoid process. These over here are the superior articulating processes with facets, and these articulate with the inferior articulating processes with facets of the upper cervical vertebrae, or C1. This is our vertebral foramen where the spinal cord runs through. This is our spinous process right there, and that's what's designed to be able to protect the spinal cord, right? Now we're going to flip it over so we can take a better view at some other structures. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to take a look here. If you see, this is a chunky part of the bone right there. That's called the body or the centrum. That's the weight-bearing effect right there of the cervical vertebrae. It's going to be where a lot of the weight is being applied, okay? Then over here, you can see these little processes over here. These processes are, again, their transverse processes. They're better seen from the inferior surface. And then again, you got these little, your transverse foramina right there, transverse foramina. And again, that's where the vertebral arteries run through. And then here, these little articulating surfaces right here, these right here are called your inferior articulating processes with facets, okay? And they'll articulate with the superior articulating processes of the lower cervical vertebrae, or C3. And again, here's your spinous process, protects the spinal cord. And then again, there's your vertebral foramen where the spinal cord runs through. Okay, so that's our C2, or axis. All right, guys, so now I wanted to show you the articulation between C1 and C2, or atlas and axis. So again, you can actually see that part right there, the odontoid process, how it's articulating and pivoting around that point right there, that articulating surface right here in the where the anterior tubercle is, or the anterior arch. I wanted to show you that. And then also, you can see the articulation here. If I kind of turn this over a little bit, you can see here's your inferior articulating surfaces, processes with facets for your C1 and how it articulates with the superior articulating process facets of C2. And again, that interaction, the articulation between those two points and where this odontoid process is sitting, is what allows for this joint to move from side to side or pivot around that central axis. So it allows for the C1 to kind of pivot around that odontoid process. And it forms what's called a synovial pivot joint. All right, so that covers, again, in this video, C1 and C2, or atlas and axis.